Hi y'all, it's Terhi here. Today I have really simple idea of a layout, and even though the idea is really simple and the techniques I'm going to use to make this layout are really, really simple and not that much mixed media or not that much anything, I really love the layout, how it looks, because it looks like it was really difficult and tricky and layered to do, but actually it was like the easiest thing ever. I'm still playing with May Hip Kits because for some reasons the custom in Finland is not my best friend this month, but let's not talk about that. I'm just happy with playing with these products. These feathers and flowers and XOXO is exclusive ephemera from Hip Kit Club included to make kits. And as you see, I made some holes to some of the ephemera pieces, and I'm using regular thread to make some kind of now I have no idea what's the right word for this, but anyway, you are seeing what I'm doing with the thread. So I'm doing to each and every one of the ephemera pieces this same trick. I'm adding some thread. Same goes with the feathers, same goes with the words, and same goes with, no, not with the flowers, but all the feathers. These bigger feathers are from the ephemera pack, and the little ones are made from Dear Lizzie paper from Hip Kit Club May paper kit. And I used some feather dye to cut them. And I really love the effect. There's actually some fun thing in this layout. All the pieces of patterned paper you are seeing, this one, which I'm right now using, and the one I made the doily from, these are all the same. It's from the Dear Lizzie Lovely Day line, and I really love the way it's partly blue, partly light orange, partly yellow, and it's really beautiful. And well, I can't say nothing more, but it's really beautiful. So I cut it to doily with it too, and now I'm adding these ephemera pieces with the thread to the doily. And that's it. That's my super big secret for this layout. I'm just making light knots to each one so they will stay there. I will use some glue or double-sided tape to make them really stick there, because I don't want anything to be loose. I'm going to put this to the album, and if I put it to album and everything is loose, it will not be that pretty. But anyway, I'm adding all of these here, and then I'm gluing them up, and then I'm going to add the photograph on top, and that's it. As I said, it was really, really simple. Really simple to do, even though the idea was like, oh, I want to make some kind of dream catcher thing for this layout, but I'm not sure how to do it, or should I mix lots of different patterned papers to make the round piece, or should I cut the feathers by my hand or something. But no, this was good, and I like the way that there is something text, like the XOs and I don't remember what it says on the golden one, but anyway, I love the way that there is some text and there is some feathers, and now I'm adding some flowers here and there with 3D foam to make some layers. And it really, it looks much, much trickier than it really is. I wanted to use this navy blue or dark blue flowers too for this layout, because it needed some contrast. There are some black areas on the photograph, so I wanted to add something, maybe not black, but something dark on the layout too, so it will look much better. I also considered to put that little heart somewhere, but it didn't match at all, so it didn't go there. Also, the title is dark blue or navy blue, what matters the most, our family, of course, and it also repeats the darker things. At this point, I was already really pleased for this layout, but I thought some little enamel dots wouldn't hurt anyone, right? So I added some blue and some yellow, as there is on the patterned paper, and some really light blue too, and then some drops of watercolors and mists on top, but not much. You can see it on the detailed pictures, but as I said, not much. And that was it. It was really fun to do this super simple layout, and I hope you will try it. And if you do so, please tag me to your layout wherever you post it. I want to see it. Thank you for watching. I hope you are inspired, and we'll see you again next week. Thanks. Bye.